country, you can get to be somewhere around 8 words. There's a long-standing debate whether essential tremor patients are predisposed to getting Parkinson's disease. I think that is beyond the scope of our discussion here today, but it's very possible that older patients, when they develop what looks like ET, may be more likely to get PD later. But those patients that have had essential tremor since teenage years, I don't think they are more susceptible. So I think there may be two different diseases which we are lumping, and that's why there's controversy. There's some say that yes, essential tremor clearly predisposes you to develop Parkinson's disease. Others say no, it's either a chance association or the postural tremor was the first manifestation of Parkinson's disease. And I think time will tell what's correct. I think essential tremor is not one disease. That's the problem. Treatment will be covered by Dr. Diego Mestre. And I'm going to move on now to some other unusual tremors. Focal, isolated, task-specific tremors. Sometimes they're positional, not just task-specific. Other times they only occur on a given task. And they can be very specific to a task. For example, they could happen only on writing and not drawing a spiral. Sometimes it can only occur on a downstroke of writing, not upstroke. Very task specific. So physicians get it in their hands, sports people, tremor while putting only, not while anything else. It could be part of the yips, which is, if you're a golfer, you know what I'm talking about. You can have wind instrument players, they have tremor when they close their lips. So there's a sportsman, he's a professional golfer. He had tremor only while chipping, but he also had it in certain positions of the hand. He came to me and he would say, I got to play in the seniors tournament, and I want you to fix me and I'll make you famous. I said, I don't need that, I need some money. I said, I'm already famous. So here he gets tremor only in that position. And we did a deep brain stimulation on him. And in the OR, we had him, he was conscious, had a hole in his head on the right side. And they placed a thalamic deep brain stimulation. And then they asked him to hold it. So once they reached the right target, they stimulated it and saw that his hand was steady as a rock. So that's when we knew we were at the right spot. And we operated on him. And he went ahead to play in the seniors open and won a lot of money. He didn't give me any, but he's thankful. Okay, so task-specific tremors and these positional tremors have probably a different mechanism than essential, typical postural action tremor. I think these are all variations of the dystonic tremor. Okay? Now, dystonic tremor is a relatively recently elaborated, recognized entity. This is a postural action-specific tremor. It's not there at rest in most cases, but it can be there. You have dystonic posture. You have tremor, but you also may have a little bit of the dystonic posturing. In the neck, it's pretty clear sometimes. It often involves the arms, the head, and very rarely the legs. In fact, leg tremor occurs more so in Parkinson's disease than any of the other tremor syndromes. There's a man who clearly has a head tremor. Yes, it's a no-no tremor. As a family member or two with as well. But you see, it'll get much worse in a certain position. dystonic tremor. Here's a man with a long-standing history of tremor in the hands, and you notice abnormal position of his hands. He's been treated for essential tremor for years. When he came to me, he showed these abnormal positions. Of course, he has some arthritis in his fingers as well. But he also told me his lips and jaw has started to shake. And you'll see that in a second. Unfortunately, he has a beard. It's not easy to see. But you will see it. Whenever he opens his mouth slightly, he starts to have this jaw tremor. But you see how it shakes? The Q-tip is shaking, and he feels that. And this man, in fact, the hand postures and everything it suggests, and it only occurs in a certain, when he opens the jaw slightly, not when he opens it fully. This is also an example of dystonic tremor. There's an entity called pot, and I'm not talking about marijuana. Pot. P-O-T, primary orthostatic tremor. It's a disease of unknown etiology. There's a syndrome called orthostatic tremor plus, which can occur as a component of some other disease, but we'll just talk about this primary orthostatic tremor. It affects the legs and the trunk, sometimes the arms, sometimes the whole body. It's a very fast tremor, and there's extremely high degree of coherence. If you sample their arm muscle, sample their toe muscle, they're all going at the same frequency, same time, which means there is one generator in the brain, not multiple generators like in Parkinson's. You can have one hand going at one frequency, the second hand going at the other, legs could be doing something else. There are many generators in Parkinson's. Pot has one generator, we don't know where it is exactly, but it is this. One generator. So they stand up and they feel very unsteady. I had an attorney who, when he was giving evidence, he kept pacing. And the judge will say, "Why don't you stop and talk, sir? I don't like you to be pacing. This is not a Perry Mason movie." And he said, "Sir, I can't stand you." He said, "You need to get a medical certificate." So I had to give him a medical certificate that he has orthostatic tremor because it gets better with walking. Strange disorder. And you measure the frequency. This is the only time I Oscar date somebody's thigh and people become crazy. So you can hear it. So this lady has nothing on sitting. As soon as she stands, it's hard to see because it's very fine. But they complain of unsteadiness. One of the signs is, look at how fast it is. It's for 60 hertz. When she sits down, she's fine. If she leans back, she's fine. Primary orthostatic tremor. One of the signs is they carry this golf spectator's chair. One of the signs for essential tremor is they have a straw in their pocket. They can only drink with a straw. And for POT, primary orthostatic tremor, if you have a golf in the spectator seat, they can just sit down wherever they're lying, they just sit down. And this patient actually discovered another patient in a grocery store with a golf thing. And she said, "What condition do you have?" "Oh, I have primary orthostatic tremor." "Oh, I do too. Who do you see?" "I see Sethi." "Oh, I see Sethi too." So they became the best of friends. So remember, the golf chair sign is very important. So again, very high frequency, 16 hertz. You'll hear more about it at the next lecture. Now coming to other types of tremor, symptomatic tremor, disease, midbrain disease, midbrain stroke, thalamic infarction, neuropathies, and then of course drug induced, we talked about it already. This is a gentleman with multiple sclerosis who has a severe action in attention tremor, disabling. It's a slow frequency, high amplitude tremor, also called Holmes, H-O-L-M-E-S, Holmes tremor. This is a feature of cerebellar outflow disease, dentatorubral rubrothalamic tract, superior cerebellar peduncle, lesion sometimes in the midbrain can cause this tremor as well. Very difficult to treat. You can weight these limbs, put a pound or two bracelets, heavy bracelets can help. We had to do a deep brain stimulation in him, which was only partly successful. So low frequency tremor made worse by action and precise movements, or terminal kinetic tremor, also known as intention tremor, is a feature of cerebellar tremor, low frequency. When sitting, these people can have a rhythmic trunk and neck movement, which is called titubation. The midbrain tremor, dark different names have been given to it. It's low frequency, it's worse in some postures, can be present at rest. Multiple different disorders cause it. We covered MS. There's an overlap with cerebellar outflow tremor as well, and it's probably a similar condition. Vascular disease, strokes, Wilson's disease can cause a proximal tremor as well. This lady developed the right hemisensory loss and right hemianopsia, and about 3 months later, she developed this tremor. So this one you should be able to localize. Don't look at the tremor, but listen to my earlier statement that she has right hemibody sensory loss and she has right hemianopsia. Anybody tell me where was her stroke? Any of the students? Students? Hemisensory loss, like this, complete. Where does that happen? Which part of the brain? Almost like you split the body in half. And it can be very painful in the long run. Huh? Yes? Yes, balance. And hemianopsia, of course, occurs from sometimes from posterior circulation, so posterior cerebral artery, or radiation, and even the tracts sometimes. But this lady has this tremor that's at rest, made worse by action, and trying to do precise movement. There is a stroke. It's posterior cerebral artery territory and involves the posterior thalamus. Posterior thalamus, of course, initially she might have had some edema as well. But posterior thalamus is a typical place where you have these complex tremors. Slow tremor again. It's got